We are here to perform a gender verification test approved by the National Athletic Association. What is your gender?
That's a powerful clip from the new short film, Let Her Run, all part of an international campaign to end discrimination against women who are barred from competing in high-level sports because of hormonal restrictions. Advocates say that the practice of sex testing, in particular, disproportionately discriminates against racialized women and queer and trans people in sports.
If you're looking into gender in sport, you can't avoid focusing on the long history of sex testing for women athletes only as a huge part of gender inequality in sport.
Travers is a professor at SFU and has written extensively about the intersection of social justice and sport.
And because sports is so sex segregated and sex differentiated, it's a really difficult place for trans kids.
They are also a consultant for the International Let Her Run campaign. The campaign's new short film depicts a female athlete in a sex verification test, something Travers says all female competitors were subjected to by the International Olympic Committee starting in the 1960s.
All women competitors were required to literally stand and be evaluated, much like in the example from the video, to determine if they were actually women or not.
Are you sure a woman?
Yes.
Are you sure?
Yes.
So their genitals were subject to, visual scrutiny. That was considered, understandably, as incredibly invasive and demeaning.
Travers says this practice was eventually replaced by chromosome testing and a number of other different tests to verify the sex of women.
None of them have had scientific veracity, meaning none of them have been consistently supported by the science.
Mid-distance runner Caster Semenya from South Africa is an assigned female at birth woman, but because the International Association for Athletic Federations defines women by their testosterone levels, Semenya can't compete in the events that she typically dominates in, even if her testosterone levels are naturally higher.
We have women who are naturally higher in testosterone, so the scale itself is a deliberate effort to confine the range of womanhood to just some women. We see women of color disproportionately targeted. We see someone like Caster Semenya forced to undergo medical therapy to change her body from what it is in order to fit this category of which she's already a member of.
You can watch the film online by going on YouTube and searching hashtag Let Her Run. In Vancouver, Kyrgyz Junos, City News.